open the heaven of insight and of revelation unto us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus, the most powerful name, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. We give God praise this morning for bringing us again to His presence. I'm so glad to welcome you to this service. Being the first Sunday in the month of June, we give God all the praise. So many people are nowhere to be found. A lot are happening in this generation. But by the grace of God, the Lord kept you and me. The Lord sustained us, and He still granted us life. May His name be praised forever in Jesus' name. This month for us has been declared a month of reformation. May the Lord bring about that reformation in your life in Jesus' name. Everything that needed to be reformed in your life, the Lord will reform in the name of Jesus. All right, this month, we'll be looking at the theme or the title I call, What to Do When Nothing Seems Working in Your Life. What to do when nothing seems working in your life. It's going to be an hope series on hope. It's going to be a series on hope. Our last discussion was series on purpose. And this month shall be series on hope. You know, having discovered your purpose in life, it's possible that you have tried working on a lot of things. You have tried doing a lot of things. You have tried so many things and it seems not working. And I need to tell you that I choose seems because some of us may want to hear what to do when nothing is working in your life. But I use the word seems. You will understand the reason why I use the word seems as we continue. So, by the grace of God, this commission is meant to give you hope in life. It's meant to give you hope for life. And it is meant to give you hope to live for. So because of that, this month, we'll be looking at what to do when nothing seems working. May the Lord make this to begin to work again in your life in Jesus' name. You know, sometimes you might have come to a point in life when you look around yourself and all you can say is nothing is working. You look at your finances, your marital life, your relationship, your career, your this, your business, your that. You say, nothing is working. Now, the question is, what do you do when nothing seems working? What and what can you do? And that will be trusting the Lord to look at this month. And I pray that at the end of this month, things will begin to work again in your life in Jesus' name. Not just at the end of this month, as you begin to hear these words and you put them into actions, things shall begin to work again in your life in Jesus' name. Now, this morning I have messages of hope. I have messages of consolations for you. And I know that at the end of this morning, your life will be reformed again. Your hope will rise again in the name of Jesus. All right, number one. What to do when nothing seems working in your life? Number one, don't believe that lie from the pit of hell that nothing is working in your life. That's the first thing. Don't believe that lie from the pit of hell that nothing is working in your life. You see, like I told you, I said I chose the word seems because devil wants you to believe that nothing is working. But I'm glad to tell you this morning that that is a lie. The fact that you are still alive means something is still working. At least your body is part of your life. If they are still functioning, it means something is still working. Now, devil wants you to believe that nothing is working. Now, let me tell you this. You may or you might have lost so many things. But the fact that God does not allow you to lose everything means that something is still working in your life. Devil wants you to believe that nothing can work. Devil wants you to believe that since nothing seems working, then nothing is going to work and nothing is working. But I'm glad to tell you that you are still alive means that something is still working and that things will still work in your life. I say things shall begin to work in your life in the name of Jesus. Things shall begin to work in your life in the name of Jesus. Look at Psalm 34 verse 18. Psalm 34 verse 18 says, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted. He rescues those whose spirits are crushed. Now, perhaps you are in a situation where your heart is broken. Perhaps you are in a situation whereby your spirits are crushed. Perhaps you are in a moment whereby everything around your life seems crushed. Your heart is broken, your spirits are crushed. You look and look and look and say, nothing is working, nothing is working, nothing is working. But the word of God says, the Lord is close to you. That means something is still working. The fact that the Lord is close to you means that at least one thing is still working. If nothing seems working, God is still working. Hallelujah. As far as you still have life, means God is still working about your matter. It means God is still working about your case. As long as you still have life, means something, at least that something is God, is still working. He said, the Lord is close. Can I tell you this? The time that God is closest the most is when you are broken and when you are crushed. You may not know, but that is the time that is very much there with you. Now, there was a particular person. God showed him a particular revelation. He was moving and moving and moving, and he was seeing four steps. 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 Along the line, he started seeing two steps. Now, when he was seeing four steps, by the moment when things were fine in his life, when things were rosy, and he was seeing the steps of God and himself, that they were moving together. Now, when things got bad, he started seeing two steps. Then he questioned God. He said, God, when things were good, I saw you. We were moving together. We were working together. And I was enjoying your company. I was enjoying that companionship. I was enjoying that fellowship. God, what happened? When I was broken, when I was crushed, when nothing seems working in my life, you left me, you deserted me. I couldn't see you again. You know what God said? God said, that time when you only seen two footsteps, that was my step. I carried you. Because you could no longer walk in that situation. Because you could no longer survive in that situation. So I needed to carry you. So I was the one you were seeing and not yourself. Glory to God. You see, when you seem crushed, when you seem broken, that is the time that God is closest the most. Hallelujah. When it seems as if nothing is working, God is still working. Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. You see, when it seems as if nothing is working, God is still working. He said, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you. For I know, that is God speaking. For I know the plans I have for you. When nothing seems working, believe that God is planning something out. When nothing seems working, God is planning some things out for you. When nothing seems working, God is thinking about you at that time. So something is still working. Don't believe that lie when they will tell you. You can see now that nothing is working. Even God has abandoned you. That is a lie from the pit of hell. He said, for I know, I am still working on your matter. I am still committed to you. He said, look at this. He said, for I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. You see, the Lord is committed to giving you a brighter future and a glorious hope. Don't give up. Don't give up. God is able to do all things. He's able, able. Dry bones shall rise again. When it seems as if nothing is working, God is still working. In fact, that is the time that God is busy the most about your life. You see, the time when things are working and you felt you're enjoying God, you are fellowshipping together, you are enjoying that companionship. Yeah, that's the truth. That time, it's as if God is only enjoying your companionship, he's only enjoying your fellowship. But when things are not working, that is when God is working on your behalf. He's working things out in your favor. Don't give up on God. Don't walk out on him. Don't slam the door on God. Psalm 115 and verse 1, 2, 3. Psalm 115. You see, when it seems as if God is far, I am telling you that is when God is closest the most. Look at this, Psalm 115. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name goes all the glory, for your failing love and faithfulness. Now look at this. Why let the nations say, where is their God? Now you might have been in that situation where it seems as if people are even asking you, where is your God? You say you have a God. Where is God now? Why can't he save you? They are querying your beliefs. The situations around you are querying your beliefs. The situations that surround your life are querying your convictions. Look at verse 3. He said, our God is in the heavens, and he does as he wishes. Oh man. He's doing that which pleases him. You see, God is still in heaven, well seated, and working on your behalf. So when nothing seems working, don't believe that lie. God is still working. He's working something out. And that which God is working on your behalf, I speak by the word of the Lord that speedily it will come into reality in the name of Jesus. I said speedily it will come into reality in the name of Jesus. Look at verse 9 of that same Psalm 115 from verse 9. He said, oh Israel, trust in the Lord. I am telling you this morning, trust in the Lord. I say it again, I say trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. He's your helper and your shield. In those moments of life, when you are downcasted, when you are broken, when you are crushed, trust in the Lord. Because the Lord is still at work on your matter. He said, O priest, O descendant of Aaron, trust the Lord. He's your helper and your shield. All you who fear the Lord, trust the Lord. He's your helper and your shield. May the Lord help you. I say may the Lord help you. In that situation, may the Lord help you. He will bring you out of it in the name of Jesus. The Lord is working on your behalf. He's working things out. Sincerely. When things seem toughest the most, that is when God is at the peak of what he's doing. Remember the Lord. He said the Lord remembers us. That's verse 12. And will bless us. He will bless the people of Israel. And bless the priest, the descendant of Aaron. He will bless those who fear the Lord, both great and low. May the Lord bless you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. In the name of Jesus. You see, when it seems as if things are not working, the Lord is closest the most. And I say that with all sense of responsibility, that the Lord is closest the most. Now look at Psalm 116. I want to read from verse 1 to 8. You see, so many people have been through this situation that you seem to be going through now. So many people, look at this. He said, I love the Lord because he hears my voice and my prayer for mercy. Because he bent down to listen, I will pray as long as I have breath. Don't let what you are going to take prayer from you. Don't let it take you away from God. Verse 2. He said, death wrapped his robes around me. The terrors of the grave overtook me. I saw only trouble and sorrow. This is somebody going through pains and agony.
He's going through that moment of life that is not palatable. He's going through that situation that seems terrible. He's going through that period of time when all seems lost, when all seems hopeless, when even the future seems bleak, when even the present cannot be trusted. He said, the only thing I saw are sorrows and troubles. If David could survive, you will survive. I said you will survive. In the name of Jesus. He said, I saw only sorrows and troubles. I don't know what is happening around you. And it seems the only thing you are seeing are sorrows and troubles. But I'm telling you that God is working on your matter. Don't give up. He said, then I call on the name of the Lord. Please, Lord, save me. How kind the Lord is, how good He is. So merciful this God of ours. The Lord protects those of childlike faith. Oh, glory. I was facing death and He saved me. You see, you need to have the faith like that of a child that believes that my God can still do it. It is not over for you yet.
No.
It's not over yet. As long as you still have life, something is still working. And that is your life. Since your life is still working, then every other thing will still work. In the name of Jesus. Every other thing will still work. You might have tried this, zero. Try this, no way. Try that, no way. This one, no way. Option A, fail. B, fail. C, fail. Even to option Z, fail. You said, since I have finished all the alphabets, what else remains? You have only finished the English alphabet. You have not finished others. In fact, you have not even touched some. Oh man. I was facing death and He saved me. Beloved, say no to depression. Don't allow those things you are going through get you depressed. Because depression will lead to suicidal thoughts. And we say, since nothing is working around me, this life does not even worth living. What am I living for? All I have ever lived for, I see them crashing and collapsing. Then why should I still live again? I should not die. But no! Everything came crashing while Job was still alive. He did not kill himself. As long as you still have that life, something is still working. You shall begin to see the reality in the name of Jesus. Now look at verse 7. He said, let your soul be at rest again. Let your soul be at rest again. For the Lord has been good to me. He saved me from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling. May the Lord wipe away your tears. In the name of Jesus. I say the Lord will wipe away your tears. He will remove those sorrows from you. In the name of Jesus. You see, when it seems as if nothing seems working, God is still at work. He will save you again. He will remove those fears. He will remove your tears. In the name of Jesus. And things shall begin to work again in your life. In the name of Jesus. Therefore, say no to depression. Say no to those suicidal thoughts. Don't allow the devil to get you depressed. Say nothing is working, nothing is working. Kill yourself. That's a lie. Tell yourself it's a lie. Something is still working in my life. And things shall begin to work better. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Number two, don't give up. Don't ever give up. Don't ever give up. Romans 15:13. Lord Jehovah is able to do all things. He is able, shall rise again. Dry bones shall rise again, oh. Dry bones shall rise again. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up on God, cause He won't give up on you. He's able. Romans 15:13. I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust Him. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. I told you I've come this morning to give you hope to live for again. Don't give up. Let me divine hope for you. Hope is the confident expectation that something good is going to happen. Hope is the confident expectation that something good is going to happen. Please don't lose your hope. But most of all, don't lose your hope. Don't give up. Because something good is still going to happen to you again. Say a better amen. I say something good is still going to happen to you. In the name of Jesus. Hope is a confident expectation that something good is going to happen. And it will happen. Your hope will not be dashed. Said, I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and hope, with joy and peace. Then you will overflow with confident hope. It is not just a guesswork. It's a confident hope that things will still work in your life. In the name of Jesus. I say things are still going to work in your life. In the name of Jesus. Let's see 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles chapter 15. 2 Chronicles 15. And verse 5 to 7. 2 Chronicles 16. 15. 5 to 7. During those dark times, it was not safe to travel. Brother, since you are going through dark time, sister, it seems the time around your life are dark. It's a dark time. It seems the situations around you are dark period. It seems things around you are dark. The future is dark. The present is bleak. The past is nothing to write home about. It was not safe to travel. That is, to move on is not safe for you because you don't know what happens next. It's a very terrible time. Problems trouble the people of every land. It seems problems are troubling your life. Problems there and there. Spiritually, financially, maritally, earthwisely, this way, problem, that way, problem, front, problem, back, everywhere. All you seems to be seeing, seems to be talking about problem. Nations fought against nation and city against city, for God was troubling them with every kind of problem. Look at verse 7. He said, but as for you, be strong and courageous. For your work, you will be rewarded. But as for you. Glory to God. You see, as for you, there is still hope. Even though for many others, their hope may seem to be dead. But as for you, there is still hope. He said, for your work shall be rewarded. You see, it seems as if your labors are not yielding. It seems as if your efforts are not bringing profits. But this is God's word to you this morning. 2 Chronicles 57. Be ye strong therefore, and let not your hand be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. But as for you, say this and say, as for me, I will be strong. As for me, I will be courageous. As for me, I will have hope again. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. Say, but as for you, be strong and be courageous. For your work will be rewarded. You see, your labors are not in vain. The Lord did not forget you. He did not forget you. He's working on your matters.
and your work shall be rewarded.
Those efforts that you have put into those things will not go in vain. It seems as if all your efforts were wasted, but they were not wasted. Don't be tired. Don't give up. Don't stop trying. Don't stop trying. I said, I've tried this, it's not working. I've tried this, it's not working. I've tried this, it's not working. Then I'm not trying again. No. Don't give up. Don't give up. Because your labors are not wasted. Look at Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 16. Jeremiah 31, 16. Jeremiah 31, 16. Jeremiah 31, 16. Is a word for you this morning. Jeremiah 31, 16. Oh my, Debra Galabroso. Jeremiah 31, 16. But now, this is what the Lord says. Do not weep any longer. Hallelujah. The Lord said, do not weep any longer. Refrain your voice from weeping. Refrain your voice from weeping. The Lord said, do not weep any longer. Why? For thy work shall be rewarded. Do not weep any longer, for I will reward you, says the Lord. You see, the Lord himself says he will reward you. You see, for all your efforts, for all your labors, they are not in vain. The Lord is keeping them. He has a book of record, he's keeping them. He said, I myself will reward you. The economy may not reward you. The nation may not reward you. People may not reward you. But the Lord himself said, I myself will reward you. You know what he told Abraham? He said, I am your reward. Not just your reward. I am your shield and your exceeding great reward. And you remember what we read in the Psalms? He said, is your shield and your reward. Is your shield and your reward. He said, I will reward you. So don't give up. Don't give up. Tell yourself, I will not give up. Because it's not over. Don't throw in the towel. You might have been losing before, but you can still win in the final round. Don't give up. Do you know why you should not give up? Verse 17. He said, there is hope for a future. Say to yourself, there is hope for my future. There is hope for your future, says the Lord. You see, it is not Iman that said it. I don't know what anybody has said about it. Said, you, there is nothing for you. You can't amount to anything. That is their opinion. Don't forget, we just talking about purpose. They were not the one that created you, so they can't say anything about your life. They were not there when God was making you. He that made you said there is hope for your future. He that formed you in your mother's belly said there is hope for your future. You should be excited and say something is working. Your future is working and your future will work in the name of Jesus. No matter what devil think is doing, your future is working and your future will work in the name of Jesus. Don't believe those lies from the pit of hell that say nothing is working. Something is working. In fact, greater things are working because your future is working. God is working it out. And it will work. You only need to cooperate with God so that which is doing can work. Your future is working in the name of Jesus. Verse 17, Jeremiah 31, 17. He said, there is hope for your future. Don't give up. The God of hope said, there is hope for your future. I have come to give you hope this morning. That there is hope for your future. Don't go their way. Don't do what they are doing. They said the intent is to scam. The intent is to do this. The intent is to lie. The intent is to steal. The intent is to go the ways of the darkness. I am telling you, there is hope in your future. Don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. Don't give up. Don't walk out on God. Don't say, this God can never save. He's still saving. And he will save you. He will save you. He will save you. I am so sure of that. Because he said there is hope for your future. Can I tell you this? What God can do with your future has nothing to do with your past or your present. Don't say, if I look at my past and what is happening to me in the present, my future does not look like anything meaningful. No, it has no correlation. It does not align. Esther, an orphan. Oh man. No father, no mother. Only if she's an uncle. How on earth could she ever dream that she'll never become a queen? Now, the best that could have happened to her was to marry somebody among her tribe. And as at that time, they were slaves. Oh man. But the God that can bring a slave from the pits to sit with rulers did that for our future. There is hope in your future. Your future is working. I say your future is working. And it will work in the name of Jesus. The Lord said there is hope in your future. When nothing seems working, believe what I'm telling you this morning. That something is still working. So what do you do when nothing seems working? Believe God. Number three, always remember that there is nothing permanent. Always remember that there is nothing permanent. Nothing is permanent except God. Always remember this, that nothing, I said, and I said again, nothing is permanent except God. No matter your situation, it's not permanent. It is just for a temporary time. He said, there is time for everything. And this also shall surely pass. The good news I have for you this morning is, that which you are going through now will surely pass. It's just for a time. Oh, look at this. Have you not been in some certain terrible situation much more than this? That you are now, that you thought that would be your end. Does it end you? No, you are still alive. Yes, oh fine. Then this also cannot end you. Nothing is permanent. Only God is permanent. And because He's the only one that is permanent, then He can change anything. As far as this our Father is concerned, He can change anything. Only that He cannot lie and He cannot fail. You see, this God cannot fail. And He's the only thing that is permanent. And He has the power and the authority to change everything. Therefore, look beyond the present. What you are going through now is not enough to define you. Don't let anybody call you barren because you don't yet have a child. Don't let anybody call you those names. Your present situation is not enough to give you an identity. No. No. Don't let anybody give you that wrong identity. It's not an identity. Because even that is not permanent. They call some people permanent secretary. Are they permanent? No. It is just for that time they will retire. And they don't go with it, they drop it. So there is nothing called permanent. There is nothing called permanent situation. None. It does not exist. God has not created any permanent situation. Every situation are meant to be for some certain time. I mean certain time. Ephesians 1, 18 to 19. Ephesians 1, 18 to 19. Ephesians 1, 18 to 19. They are meant for some certain time. Ephesians 1, 18 and 19. I pray that your heart will be flooded with light so you can understand the confident hope He has given to those He called, His only people, who are rich, who are His rich and glorious inheritance. I also pray that you understand the incredible greatness of God's power for us who believe. This is the same mighty power. It's a glorious inheritance. You have a glorious inheritance.
you only need to believe it. Glory to God. In that Peter's, he said, after you have suffered for a while, then he will establish you. You see, whatever thing you are going through now is only meant to last for a while. It is not forever. There is nothing like permanent situation. God has not created that. There is nothing like forever. God has not done that. God has not done that. He said, after you have suffered for a while, it is only meant for a while. He said, while you were waiting, all of those things are meant to be for a while. And you always read in your spirit and said, and it shall come to pass. This also shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus. And said, that which you are going through shall come to pass. You will go over it. And you will look back and say, so this is what God wants to bring out of this. And that way you should not give up on God. Because that which you are going through will also come to pass. In the name of Jesus. And finally this morning, what do you need to know? Number four, you need spiritual help. You need spiritual help. You see, when nothing seems working, what you need is the help of the Spirit. You need spiritual help. John 14. John 14. 26 and 27. John 14. 26 and 27. You see, what you need is the spiritual help, is the help of the Spirit. 26 and 27. But when the Father sent the advocate as my representative, that is the Holy Spirit, he will teach you everything and will remind you everything I have told you. Glory to God. You see, in a time when nothing seems working, God seems far, you need the Holy Spirit to remind you his promises, to remind you his word. You need the ministration of the Holy Spirit. Perhaps you just lost someone so precious to you and felt, ha! The word has come crashing on my head. You need the help of the Holy Spirit. And he's always there to help you. 27, he said, I am leaving you with a gift. Peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Hebrews 13:5. Hebrews 13:5. Don't be afraid. God is working something out. Look at what he said in Hebrews 13:5. He said, don't love money. Be satisfied with what you have, for God said, I will never fail you. I will never abandon you. You need the Holy Spirit to keep reminding you this. John 19, 26 and 27. John 19, 26 and 27. John 19, 26 and 27. When Jesus saw his mother standing there beside the disciple, he said, dear woman, here is your son. And his disciple said, here is your mother, and from there on, the disciple took her into his home. You see, you need that comfort. You need brethren. You need spiritual help. When you're in a difficult time, in a difficult situation, you need the help of the Holy Spirit. Finally, Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 6. You need to read that. Deuteronomy 31, verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 31. And verse 6 says what? Deuteronomy 31, 6. So be strong and be courageous. Do not be afraid and do not panic before them.
For the Lord your God will personally go ahead of you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you. The Lord himself will personally, praise the Lord. You see, God himself is going into your future. He cannot fail you and he will not abandon you. I have this promise for you that your past may have nothing to write home about. Your present may not seem encouraging, but God is going into your future to make this work out for you in the name of Jesus. But you need the help of the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, you can't go far. In fact, the challenges tend to weigh you down. They tend to make you to go away from God. But with the help of the Holy Spirit, you can go far. Do you need this help this morning? Bow down your head and let us pray. You can say, Lord Jesus, thank you for sending your word to me in such a time like this. I know I can't go through this except the Holy Spirit help me. Holy Spirit, I need you. Come into my heart. I need your help. I need your courage. I need your comfort. I need your encouragement. Please help me. I come to you this morning. I receive the help of the Holy Spirit. I receive the administration of the Holy Spirit. I receive the comfort of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for helping me. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now let me pray for the church. I pray for you. The Lord himself will go into your future and make things to begin to work for you. In the name of Jesus, things shall begin to work in your favor. In the name of Jesus, there shall be reformation in your life. In the name of Jesus, you will not go hopeless. You will not give up. In the name of Jesus, things shall begin to work again. New hope is coming to you. Strength is coming to you. In the name of Jesus, you will not be depressed. You will not commit suicide. The Lord will lift you again. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus, the most powerful name, we pray. Amen. So shall it be in Jesus.